Hey friends, this video is about a simplified version of near reflex. First of all, let's see what is a near reflex is. When gaze shifts from far object to near object, three things happen. Firstly, the convexity of lens increases, there is a constriction of pupil known as meiosis, and there is medial rotation of eyeball. Near reflex is in fact a combination of two reflexes, convergence reflex and accommodation reflex. Convergence reflex is the contraction of pupil on convergence and accommodation reflex is the contraction of pupil on accommodation. Now let's see the pathways. The afferent pathway of convergence reflex is still not elucidated. It is assumed that the afferents from the medial recti travel centrally via the third cranial nerve, that is the oculomotor nerve, to the mesencephalic nucleus of the fifth cranial nerve, that is the trigeminal nerve, to a presumptive convergence center in the tectal or pretectal region. From this, the impulse is relayed to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus, and the subsequent efferent pathway of near reflex is along the third nerve, that is the oculomotor nerve. The efferent fibers relay in the accessory ganglion before reaching the sphincter pupillae, resulting in the constriction of pupil. The pathway of accommodation reflex initially follows the visual pathway, and the impulses are carried by the afferent fibers from the retina to the optic nerve, optic chiasma, optic tract, lateral geniculate body, optic radiations to the striate cortex. These are then relayed to the parastriate cortex. From the parastriate cortex, the impulses are relayed to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus of both sides via the occipital mesencephalic tract and the pontine center. From the Edinger-Westphal nucleus, the efferent impulses travel along the third cranial nerve, that is the oculomotor nerve, and reach the sphincter pupillae and ciliary muscle after relaying in the accessory and ciliary ganglions, resulting in the constriction of pupil.